Hello, this is Tony Heller from realclimatescience.com. The Biden administration says that they're pushing their climate agenda for the good of the poor and the middle class. The Biden administration has identified the average American family, and they say that their climate agenda will lower energy prices for the average American family by $500 a month or $6,000 a year. But reality is the exact opposite. After 9 years of declining gasoline prices since the 2020 election, they've more than doubled. The cost of energy affects everything else, and as a result of rising energy prices, food prices have skyrocketed as well. The Guardian reports that families struggling with energy bills are forced to seek refuge at McDonald's. Desperate parents are using fast food outlets as an emergency kitchen, bathroom, and living room. The Biden administration is doing the exact opposite of what they promised the American people they would do. But undaunted by reality, climate alarmists continue to push their agenda. The Guardian knows that poor people are struggling to feed their families, but they're still talking about abolishing farming. They say that farming causes climate change, so we have to stop farming in order to stop the climate from changing. Here's what Foreign Policy magazine has to say about climate change and hunger. How climate change fuels global hunger. As the climate crisis deepens, millions more people could face food insecurity. The link between climate change and hunger crises. As global emissions continue to surge, setting the world on a course to barrel past critical climate targets, the planet is rapidly becoming a place of brutal extremes, one of record heat waves, torrential rain, and searing droughts. So they're saying that the only way to save people from starving is to shut down farming, which provides the food. Foreign Policy made a lot of claims in this article, none of which have anything to do with reality. The world has always been a place of brutal extremes, record heat waves, torrential rain, and searing droughts. It has nothing to do with emissions. Reality is that hunger on planet Earth has been steadily declining to record lows. In fact, there's been a lot of improvement just over the last 20 years. NASA shows that Earth has gotten much greener over the last 35 years as carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere have increased. Attempts to demonize carbon dioxide emissions as causing hunger fly in the face of historical evidence. During the 19th century, a couple of drought-induced famines killed as many as 60 million people in India, China, and Brazil. The drought and famines of 1878 and 1896 were devastating around much of the planet. Carbon dioxide levels were very low at that time. People who claim that lower CO2 levels would make the world safer don't have much evidence to back them up. During the 1970s, there was a lot of famine in developing countries, and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration blamed them on global cooling. In the October 1974 edition of NOAA magazine, they explained how famines in India were more likely during cool periods than during warm periods. There's no evidence to back up claims that increasing carbon dioxide levels cause famine. The Biden administration said that they were going to save American families $6,000 a year with their climate agenda, but MIT says the agenda will cost $44 trillion. The Biden administration is doing the exact opposite of what they tell the American people they're doing, and it's not the first time they've done this. Joe Biden pulled the exact same scam in 2008, promising 5 million green new jobs and delivering relief to American families facing pain at the pump. Biden didn't deliver the jobs, but he has produced record pain at the gasoline pump. Toto thinks that everything we're watching is very similar to Alice in Wonderland. Whatever the Biden administration says they're doing about climate, energy, and food, they're actually doing the exact opposite. Toto has been pulling back the curtain on these scams for the past 14 years. You can visit Toto, Curie, and Caesar on the web at realclimatescience.com.